The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
As Jesus was walking along the Sea of Galilee, he saw two brothers, Simon, who is called Peter, and his brother Andrew, casting a net into the sea. They were fishermen. And he said to them, "Come after me, and I will make you fishers of men." At once, they left their nets and followed him. He walked along from there, and again saw two other brothers, James, the son of Zebedee, and his brother John. They were in the boat with their father Zebedee, mending their nets. He called them, and immediately they left their boat and their father and follow him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Our life as Christians is actually can be summarized in following Christ. So how do we summarize our life as Christian? A life that follows Christ. Because we are Christians, we follow Christ in His values, priorities, in His plan, in His will, in everything. Because we want to be like Him. Because God the Father will love in us what He saw in Jesus. If Jesus is in us, then the love of the Father will be attracted to us. So it's not our good works actually that attracts God's love. It's Jesus in us. And because He loves His Son so much, He wants to multiply the images of His Son in us. He wants to share His love for only begotten Son to those who are like His Son, whom we call adopted children of God. We continue meditating on the providence of God. So we are in the doings of God. We have left the being of God, okay? Being the nature of God. Then we have started the doings of God in creation. First day, light, corresponding to the fourth day. Creation of sun, moon, and stars. Second day, water and air, the separation. Corresponding to the fifth day, okay, creating the birds of the air and the fishes of the sea. And the third day, the creation of land. And corresponding to the sixth day, animals and plants on the land, and of course, the creation of man. On the seventh day, God took a rest, and before that, He entrusted to man and woman, Adam and Eve, the continuation of His work in this world. So He will be just be around, okay, looking after the needs of men. But the one who will decide to rule over the earth, not to abuse, but to rule over the earth, is not God, but man. So take good care of this. I entrust them to you. Then name, okay? Give names to all the animals, meaning the animals will be, will obey you, will be underneath, will be below or under you, okay? Because you name it, the one who gives the name is superior to the one being named. That's why that's the meaning of give names to all the animals. Okay? Because if you give the name, you are superior. Just like a parent. Parents give name to their children. They're superior to their children. That's why it's a taboo to mention the name of the Lord in vain. Because if you mention the name of the Lord in vain, you are more superior than the name of God. That's the theology of naming, the theology of name. That's why even until now, the Jews are afraid to mention the name of the Lord. How do you call your God? Why would they don't mention the name of God? Because for them, naming God is the act of superiority. So they are not allowed to mention the name of God. Of course, for us Christians, Jesus has revealed already the name of God. Okay? In fact, God revealed His name to Moses in the Old Testament, Yahweh, I am who am. But Jesus revealed to us the name of God, okay? And the name of God, not really the name, but the function, the relationship of God is Father. So Creator, Father. Almighty Father. Just Father. Merciful Father. What defines the attributes of God is His Father. He is almighty, but power of a Father. He is just, but the justice of the Father. Not the justice of the enemy, nor the justice of revenge, but the justice of the Father. That's why everything is qualified by the fatherhood of God. He is good, but His goodness is as being a Father. He is loyal, but His loyalty is the loyalty of the Father. That's why we call God Father, Jesus. When you pray, say, Our Father who art in heaven. So that's the nature of God, and the doings of God are always related to His fatherhood. He created the world because He is the origin of life, and Father means also the origin of life. And Father also means provider. So we meditate on the divine providence of God. We call by the name of divine providence God's preservation and government of the world. So when we say God's providence, we are referring to His maintenance of the world. He preserves all the creatures in existence. He maintains it. And He governs the course of the world. Okay. God maintains the world by His providence. That means He preserves all creatures in existence as long as He wills. Explanation from Spirago. By the way, we have already downloaded the application iPieta to your phone. Okay, it's very nice. iPieta, download. Go to Google Play, search for it. iPieta, and then download. Some parts are free, some parts are you have to pay for it. But it's sufficient for free, sufficient. So you have the readings already. Now everything that I say here, not everything. The basis of what I'm saying here is the Spirago Catechism. It's found in iPieta. Okay. A ball hanging from a piece of string falls to the ground as soon as the string is cut. We're talking here of the preservation of the existence of creature. So the whole world would sink into nothing if God were to withdraw from it His supporting power for a single instant. In order that creatures may continue to exist, He provides all that is needed for their sustenance: wheat, vegetables, various fruits of the earth, etc. As soon as God wills it, they die. So what maintains, what preserves our existence in the world is the will of God. He only has to will it, and it will be done. Let there be light. He wills it, and there was light. It's the will of God that keeps creation in existence. In Psalms, Psalm 103, verse 29, when thou shalt take away thy breath, they shall die and return again to the dust. If the sun This is an analogy. If the sun were to cease to cast its rays upon the earth, all light would disappear from the world. So if God ceased to support us in existence, our life at once fades out. When our Lord says, heaven and earth shall pass away, He does not mean that they will be annihilated, but that they will be changed into a better. St. Peter says, we look for a new heaven and a new earth wherein dwelleth justice. So, wala sang tao nga mapakabugal nga ang iya existence halin sa iya. That's why hindi matuod nga ang world created itself. Hindi man matuod nga naglutaw lang, nagtuhaw lang ang tao sa kalibutan kaangay sang dapaw sa inyo nga bugas. May nagpa-exist sa ila. That's why ining mga theory nga ini nga self-subsistent ang world, nga self-subsistent ang tao is false. Kay kun kuhaon sang Dios ang breath sa imo ilong, sa imo lungs, mapatay ka. Kun will ya na, wala ka na mahimo. Bisan pang mainugbakal ka pa sang oxygen. Tagpilangan na ng oxygen subong tag 270 ang tangke. Mahal. Bisan may libo-libo ka pa. Hindi mo na masugpunan ang imo kabuhi kung pagbuot na sang Dios. So klaro ina nga wala sing tao makapabunggal sa tubangan sang Dios. Kay ultimately, ang Dios amo ang grounds sang iya existence. God maintains the world. Sa tuod, no? Anong nag-maintain sang earth, sang life sa earth? Natural nga, no? Is sun. Kung magdulum ang sun, kag di magsingka, makala-ice kita diri. Wala na sang photosynthesis. Hindi na magpalamunga nga itong tanong. Hindi na mag-alanda electricity. Kiti, gin-transform lang na halin sa power. Wala. The same. Ambal na diri. Kung wala sang Dios, the same. Mapabugal ka. Why? Kung kwaon sang Dios ang iya nga providence, wala sa maka-exist. That's why kinahanglan, simbahon naton siya as Father, Creator. Iba niya Father, Provider lang. Father, Provider lang pangkita lang sa Dios. Pero wala sila simba siya as Father, Origin, Father, Creator. Second meaning of God's providence, He does not only maintain the world or keeps the world in existence, but He governs the world. Wow, He governs the world. He conducts all things in the world so that they contribute to His glory and to our advantage. Paano mag-govern ang Diyos sa kalibutan? When the engine is what the engine is to the train, and the pilot to the vessel, God is to the world. He guides the stars according to fixed laws. So He has His agents. He has His angels. So you remember the 9 choirs of angels? The 3 groups serve God. The 3 next group serve the world, maintains the world. Okay? And then the 3 last group supports man, guides man. Okay. So 9 choirs of angels. So God does not necessarily mean that He is the one fixing everything, but He can use His creature, His angels, okay, to provide for the world and to govern the world. He guides all nations. That's in Daniel chapter 4, verse 32. We see His guiding hand in the lives of the patriarchs, in the history of the Jews, in that of the Christian church. Yet we cannot understand God's arrangements at the first glance. Often we cannot understand them at all, and never shall till we get to heaven. Yet in our own lives, we can trace again and again the good providence of God. But as to the world, generally, we are forced to exclaim, how incomprehensible are God's judgments and how unsearchable His ways. Romans chapter 11, verse 33. Punabutang diri, God, there's no one on earth for whom God does not care and provide for his welfare. Bisan mga peace, father, nag-take care sa Dios. Yes, a mother would sooner forget her child than God would forget us. That's Isaiah. God cares even for the irrational creatures, for the beasts and birds and plants. Nadumduman ninyo pagtudlo ni Jesus about the Father? Siling niya, tanawan niyo mga pispis. Wala sila gatipon sa ilang barns. O tanawan niyo ang bulak. Wala sila gatahi sa ilabayo. Nami sila subong pagkahapon na laya na sila. Wala sila ginapabayaan sa inyo amay sa langit. Kun amu ining mga gagmay nga pispis nga daw, wala sang bili. Kaya mga bulak, galaya man lang, isa kaadlaw. Ano pagidaya ng pagtatap sang inyo amay sa langit? So that means kinatatap ya bisan ng pispis kag bulak. Kaging gamit siyang analogy. But God has a special care for those. Amuning nami, kinatatap ya tanan, pero may special preference siya. Pero sang pamilya bala, tatap mo imo bata pa eskwela mo. Pero kung magmasakit siya, may special preference, special food, special time, special care. Nabutang diri, God has a special care for those who are in humble circumstances and are despised by the world. God has made small as well as great and cares equally for them. Wisdom, Book of Wisdom. God loves to declare His glory by means of the little. 1 Corinthians 1:27. He chose poor shepherds to receive the first news of the birth of Christ. He chose the poor fishermen for His apostles, the gospel for today. A poor maiden for His mother. It is to the humble that He gives His grace, special grace. Basta mapainubuson ka. Na take care yaman ng iban, pero may special care, very special care siya sa mga humble. He raises the needy from the earth and takes the poor from the dunghill that He may place him among His princes. That's in Psalm, okay? Psalm 112, verse 7 and 8. And lastly, nothing happens to us all through our lives without the will or the permission of God. Okay? Without the will, kung sa ginabuot ya, kung sa wala ya ginabuot, pero ginapermit ya, ginaallow ya, si Satan magtempt sa aton. Pero wala sa nagakatabo sa aton, wala sang permiso sang Dios. Nagatabo sa US subong, may permiso na sang Dios. Nagatabo sa Pilipinas, COVID, may permission sang Dios. Wala sa nagakatabo outside sang iya power. Okay, either He wills it because it's good or permits it because it's bad. God does not will what is bad. He may permit what is bad, but does not will it. So, even the evil that God permits is for our good. Mga temporal misfortunes natin, for our good. Okay? Kagamuni, everything works for the good of those who love God. So, ang key para matransform sang Diyos ang misfortune mo into maayo is the love of God. Everything works for the good of those who love God. So, bisan malain kakatabo sa imo, love God. I-transform sang Diyos ang malain nga nagkatabo sa imo. Manang promise ang Bible. Bisan malain nagikatabo sa imo, ang sikreto, ang ingredient na may power ang Diyos to change it for your good is the love in your heart. When you love God, everything will work for your good. That's why, nakatabo sa atin sa Pilipinas, amo sini, hindi kita magbuhi sa love of God. Kaya mo nang ginapintain sang Diyos sa atin. Kaya hindi kita pagpabayan. So, ginapermit siyang evil matabo. Kaya anyway, may power man siya na mag-correct sina. Wala siya ga-permit sa hindi niya mahimo, ma-power nga ma-correct. Pero i-correct ya if you have faith and hope and love in Him. Because that's the magic That's the secret ingredient ng imo negative mangin positive, because ang negative mo may love of God, it becomes positive. Everything works for the good of those who love God, who worship God. Amen. Lord, in your kindness, hear our petitions. You called Andrew the apostle to preach the gospel and guide your church in faith. May he always be our friend in your presence to help us with his prayers. This we ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.